Welcome to AETCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we'll be discussing a urological emergency who have presented to us in our emergency department. Can you start the case?
Yes.
A 3-year-old male child was brought to our ED with the complaints of pain in the scrotal area for the past 4-hour duration and swelling and redness in the same area for past 2 hours duration. Our initial 10-second assessment, patient was conscious, alert, able to respond to our commands in one full sentence. In PAT assessment, tone of child is normal, child is interactive, child is consolable, and speech is normal. Breathing part, respiratory rate is normal, effort is also normal, there is no accessory muscle involvement. Circulation part, color of child is in pink, there is no mottling. In primary survey, airway is patent, there is no secretions in oral cavity, there is no stridor, there is no gurgling or pooling, there is no hoarseness of voice. Breathing, bilateral air entry is present, respiratory rate is 28 cycles per minute, saturation is 98% in room air. Circulation, BP is 92 on 64 millimeters of mercury, heart rate is 100 beats per minute, capillary refilling time is 2 seconds. Disability, GCS is E4, V5, M6, pupils are 2 millimeters equally reactive, pain score we assess, pain score is 6 out of 10. Exposure, temperature is normal, 98.4 Fahrenheit, sugars were checked at this point of time, it is 100 milligrams per deciliter.
How do you know in a 3-year child, how do you assess the pain score?
Sir, for pain assessment in pediatrics, if child can count and she is knowing numerical means, that is more than 3 years means, numerical scale itself we can use, sir. By 0 being minimum pain and 10 being maximum pain, we can ask the child to grade how much she can feel that pain, sir. Or visual analog score we can use, sir. Visual analog means in a scale there won't be anything, but one end it will be minimum and another area it will be maximum, and we can ask them to point where will you grade your pain. Or faces expressions we can use, Wong-Baker's faces is there, in which how much is your pain we can ask, sir. And child will be able to touch that face and it will express it. And after pain management, we can reassess the pain and we can label it how much it have reduced or how much it have increased, sir. These are the possible options.
Good.
And in our primary survey, pain is the only thing which have to be assessed at this point, sir. And we gave, after securing cannula, we gave paracetamol of 15 mg per kg, IV was given, and we are proceeding into secondary survey.
What are the criteria for pediatric analgesia in India? How do you
relate
pediatric analgesia management?
Yes, sir. Analgesic, mild, moderate and severe, sir. Mm-hmm. Less than 3, mild, 4 to 7, moderate and more than 7, severe, sir. Mm-hmm. And analgesics will be again divided into NSAIDs, opioids, and NSAIDs, paracetamol and opioids, sir.
Paracetamol?
NSAIDs, no opioids, sir. First, we'll start with paracetamol, no improvement, then we'll go for NSAIDs. If no improvement, then we'll go for opioid and opioids, sir. That is step ladder pattern.
Yeah. Correct. So, just adding to it, what you said is actually, so this is one thing, according to pain score.
Yes, sir.
Second thing, what we can see is understanding the diagnosis of the patient, to have an idea about the diagnosis of the patient, because pain score is different from patient to patient, and more than that, child, especially a 3-year-old child, will be irritable also,
yes,
because of the pain, because of a new environment, because of external indulgences, and that child will be irritable. So child's cry can also be secondary to the irritability rather than the pain. So minor, mild, moderate, severe can be due to the mild being any diseases which doesn't require any intervention, moderate being small interventions, for example, INDs, suturing, all these things, and severe being anything that requires any surgical intervention as such. So, in this case, the child is having mild pain. You said it's pain score of
5 to 6 out of
5
10.
To 6 is coming as moderate.
Moderate.
So, first drug of choice will be.
Two schools. One is the stepladder pattern, what we said, starting with paracetamol and hiking up, it's also possible. If we expect this patient is likely to have severe pain, for example, pain score of 8 or 10, then we can directly go for opioids itself. That, that also it is.
100%. There's no point in hiking up if the pain score is too high. But this child, right now, your PAT triangle assessment and your primary survey, are you finding any abnormality in the child which can explain the pain? Or any systemic condition that is causing the pain or that may cause the child to worsen right now?
Tachycardic response is not there, so it is on upper limit of normal, but it is within normal limit only, sir.
So right now there is no emergency that is seen in the primary survey and PAT triangle that shows that patient is in severe pain. Patient complains pain, but there is nothing to suggest emergency. So why can't we try the traditional method of giving oral analgesics with the mother being at the side of the child and consoling the child before giving IV paracetamol?
Yes, with the history that a child is having scrotal pain and swelling and redness area, we are concentrating on acute events and child can sometime be taken for surgical procedures. So we want to avoid oral and
scrotal torsion. So you are suspecting a torsion. Because of that, you want a higher analgesic. Okay.
Suppose the same child is having pain score of lower side and the patient is apprehensive, fearful and agitating, crying, then what will be the management aspect at this stage?
Pain score of 2. Pain score of 2. Child is
irritable.
Hugging the mother, crying loudly.
Pain score of 2 with same findings means then mild anxiolytics can be tried, sir, and keeping the child in mother's lap and in comfortable environment and distracting the child.
Distraction techniques is the first thing that you should, isn't it? First distraction techniques. Even with the distraction techniques also child is having pain, then only you give analgesics. So pediatric pain management is primarily is distraction based. You should always try the distraction technique before starting analgesics. When you start analgesics also, it's always better not to hike up to the IV analgesics. I'm not saying do not give, see the patient clinically, but if try to avoid as much as possible. Oral syrups, NSAIDs, either ibuprofen or paracetamol is a good choice. That is not controlled. Or the child is having higher pain in his life, having a shoulder dislocation, elbow dislocation, and you can go ahead with IV. But first, distraction techniques should be thought about.
Yes.
Then in that case, paracetamol, if you are preparing, that may be an analgesic. Pain part will be taken care of. In addition, we can go for a good choice of benzodiazepine, midazolam, small doses, just to make the child calm. So only paracetamol may not be there. Even then, the pain is abolished, child will still be agitated.
In secondary survey, child is not having any allergies, sir. Not on treatment for any diseases. Last meal is 4 hours back, sir. And events leading to this.
Last meal, what type of meal?
Last meal, child had semi-solid foods. Semi-solid food.
Whenever you tell last meal, better add one word about clear liquid or juices or milk or solid food or semi-solid food.
Yes. And events leading to this history is child had complaints of pain in the scrotal area for the past 4 hours duration and redness and swelling in the scrotal area for the past 2 hours duration, sir. There is no history of trauma, there is no history of fever, there is no history of vomitus, there is no history of skin discoloration, sir. And these were the history, sir.
Onset?
4 hours, sir.
Sudden or?
Sudden onset, sir.
Any associated abdominal pain?
No associated abdominal pain, no associated inguinal pain. Child have passed motion today, that same day morning. There is no dysuria, there is no reduced frequency or urgency, there is no hematuria also. Sir.
Good stream of urine.
Yes.
But is the mnemonic for describing the pain?
OPQRS.
That a pattern you just like that. Good.
Yes. Then in examination, in head-to-toe examinations, we couldn't find any obvious things, sir. There is no pallor, no icterus, cyanosis, clubbing or pedal edema. With this positive history, we would like to examine abdomen and scrotal region first. In abdomen, abdomen is scaphoid, obliques in midline, flanks are free, there is no scar, sinuses are dilated, veins, there is no visible intestinal pulsation or gastric pulsation, sir. In auscultation, bubble sounds are present, there is no arterial bruise, sir. Percussion, we didn't do, sir. And in a scrotal examination, in inspection, scrotum is swollen, sir. Skin is stretched and shiny. There is no necrotic tissue over skin. And rugosity of scrotum is lost, sir.
Bilateral scrotum?
Left. Bilateral it is lost, sir. Left to more than right side, sir. And in palpation, testis is firm to hard in palpation. And tenderness is also noted. And it is slightly higher than the normal portion of the, when compared to opposite side, sir. And it is in horizontal lie, sir. So, these were the examination findings, sir. And cremastic reflex, we check, sir. Cremastic reflex is absent, sir.
How was the route of testis?
Since child is having pain, we couldn't palpate cord structure, sir. And it is firm, sir. Whatever we palpated, we could see firm structure, sir.
Is there any other swelling other than testis in the scrotum?
Sir, we couldn't find any sorts of hematoma or other fluid-like contents or other small appendageal structures in which could be separately palpated other than testis, sir.
In a 3-year-old child presenting with acute abdominal pain, testicular pain, other than testicular causes, any other intra-abdominal causes that can present with the testicular pain?
Yes, sir. Hernia can be there, sir. Undescended testis is another area, sir, where we won't be able to see testis in normal area, and in other areas it will be in the tract, it will be there, sir. Or trauma causing hematoma is another possibility, sir.
Okay, so hernia we have to rule out, right?
Yes.
It's very common nowadays to have a inguinal hernia in a pediatric child, which can be missed at the time of birth or can develop after that. So it should not only be looking at a testicular examination, bubble contents or any fat, intra-abdominal contents presenting in the scrotum has to be ruled out.
Yes. Then other and thing
the
is
the hiatus, perinellum, okay, all these things examination also should be described. And any micturition, painful micturition or normal body?
No painful. Other testis also we examine, sir. Mm. Other testis is in normal position, sir. Usually if other testis is also elevated, then it is called as angel sign, sir. And if the affected testis is in horizontal lie, that is like our child, then it is called as demic sign, sir. And just checking for cremastic, that is friend sign. Checking for cremastic reflex, root value will be L1 and L2, sir, that we can do. And friend sign is elevation of testis will reduce pain in epidermoarchitis, sir.
And
yeah.
Release pain in?
Torsion. Friend sign. These are the other signs. Then with this history, we had a suspicion of testicular torsion, sir. And we proceeded with imaging, sir. Imaging of child is always ultrasound with Doppler, sir. In ultrasound, we are checking for vascularity, sir, and testicular structure, whether the appearance of testis is normal or it is edematous or it is already necrosis have happened or not. Those things we can find, sir. Then this is one thing. Then when we trace the appendages, then we can find for coiling or kinking or whirlpool sign by ultrasound we can check, sir. Those things indicates torsion in appendageal area also. And blue dot sign, that is a dot sign in superior pole of testis, which also indicate appendageal torsion. These things we can find, sir. And we did a ultrasound showing torsion of testis, sir. And urology consultation was taken and child was taken for operation in room for detorsion and epidermoarchidopexy, sir. And again this one thing what we can try is manual detorsion technique. We can try, so that is open book technique. Usually this, we have to stand at the foot end and we have to rotate the testis like opening the books. For this procedure, no need for analgesics. Thing is, when we detort the testis and child is having that pain free, then we can clearly say that because of our manure only pain have come down, we have detorted the patient. And we have to rotate 2 or 3 times, usually around 270 degrees also it is, sometime it will be needed, sir. That is one thing. Then after manual detorsion, definitely child have to be reassessed for other things, sir. And if it is failing also, then urology treatment is required and child have to be taken for operation theatre, sir.
So then during the waiting period, do you keep the testis elevated with support?
Supported, sir. Scrotal support you have to use. Then other thing is types of torsion, that is intravaginal torsion and extravaginal torsion. Intravaginal torsion is more in adult and adolescent area where during the time of puberty, sir, because of that growth, testis get detorted, torsion. And other thing is extravaginal, as in our child, in young children, that is less than 10 years, torsion is happening because of there is no support to hold that testis. This we have to check, sir. And in other imaging technique, radionucleotide scintigraphy we can do, sir, where after technetium scan we can see, trace the blood flow in the testis. Usually it will be affected in the affected kidneys.
Is that an emergency?
No, sir. No, sir.
Your, if a patient presents with this complaint, your role will be to facilitate ultrasound Doppler for the patient as soon as possible to at least suspect a torsion testis, because what is the time duration you have in your hand?
Yes. Golden hour is less than 6 hours. Within 6 hours, after 6 hours, chance of necrosis is high, and more than 24 hours, sensitivity is 90% for necrosis.
Yes. And so your role will be to make a diagnosis within
4 to 6 as soon as possible,
so that the child can be taken up for a surgical procedure and save the testis, isn't it?
Yes, sir. And pathophysiology is like, initially it will be of venous stasis, then it will be arterial stasis, then it will go for necrosis, sir. And pain, usually this pediatric patients, they won't be saying of scrotal pain also. Sometimes vague lower abdomen pain or inguinal region pain, or they may come with multiple episodes of vomiting or loose stools. That will be also a presenting complaints. That also we have to keep in mind. And in torsion testis, fever won't be a presenting complaint in most of the cases, sir. Rather than it will be pain. Whereas in epidemioarchitis, fever will be a presenting complaint and onset of pain will be very, very gradual, like 4 days, 5 days pain, and they have reached this stage. Whereas it will be more acute onset in torsion testis.
Anything else to be added? What are the common differential diagnosis for testicular pain?
In acute scrotal pain, differential diagnosis will be, one is torsion testis, appendageal torsion, trauma, hematoma, incarcerated hernia, sir. This will be the differential diagnosis. Epidemioarchitis.
Okay.
Good.